Hi, my name is Guilherme Gaia Neto, and now I will be presenting the work Early Defects Detection in Conveyor Belts using Machine Vision. Conveyor belts are widely used for the transport of bulk materials. Since they are prone to suffer from several kinds of defects, the monitoring of such equipment is a desire of the maintenance team. Furthermore, a defect in this equipment can cause the loss of capital or even worse, a fatal accident. Although a lot of defects are monitored using common methods and equipment, computer vision has been a strong candidate for such a monitoring task. So, the objective of this work is to present an automatic method based on laser, machine vision, and some other techniques like statistical and clustering techniques that are capable to detect and describe conveyor belt defects, as well as reveal the 2D shape of those defects. First, the laser line has to be out of phase of the camera. Such configuration changes the way that the laser line appears in the image, highlighting the formation caused by defects. The captured image is pre-processed with computer vision techniques, and after this operation, we transform the image into a one-dimensional signal. With this signal, we calculated the curvature of it. Our approach shows that points close to the defect get a high curvature value being described as outliers. Therefore, we use statistical techniques to extract them. These outlier points construct a defect matrix. Inside that matrix, the outliers are positioned in the same column index that they were found in the curvature signal, but the line index is updated as the conveyor moves through the video. Therefore, in each frame capture, we extract outlier points, if they exist, and update the matrix until those points appear like the defect, or, as we call, a 2D rebuild of the defect. Also, as these points are close to each other, we propose to use the Basecan algorithm to find the clusters, and that is the defect, the identification itself. This algorithm was chosen because of the simplicity and the capacity of identifying clusters, in our case defects, without knowing the number of clusters inside the data. What is the limitation of the Kamins algorithm, for example? Our method was tested with a simulated database. To simulate defects, we construct a virtual conveyor with different kinds of defects, such as rips and bubbles, for example. For the method of evaluation, was proposed to use classification metrics such as recall, precision, and affluent score. The method was capable to achieve high values in all metrics for the simulated database. With the results, we can conclude that the method was capable to achieve high values on the proposed metrics. Also, this kind of approach seems to be a reliable way for the problem of monitoring conveyor belts, being also remote and interpretable. Furthermore, the technique shows an easy way to classify defects, looking, for example, the size of the identified defects. Some of our references. This work was financed by CAPES, CNPq, FAPEMIG, Instituto Tecnológico Vale, Vale SA, and the Universidade Federal de Ouro Preto. Thank you.